Vaccinations in cattle are like an insurance because you never know when you're going to need them, and they protect your herd against diseases that come in that can have major economic implications on your herd if they get in. The best way to think about the whole vaccine program for your animals is to determine which diseases are a risk to your enterprise. When you're breeding, you want to get as many calves as you possibly can to make your enterprise viable, because that's your cash flow. So you need to think about what diseases can have a major effect on your herd and whether or not to vaccinate for those or not. There's a wide range of what people vaccinate for. Some people vaccinate for every single thing and other people don't vaccinate for a thing. I guess the biggest risk is if your herd is naive to a certain disease and whether or not you assess that disease can come into your herd and the implications of it getting into your herd. The main sort of diseases to be thinking about when you're vaccinating cattle are leptospirosis for all breeding stock. That is a disease that is spread through sexual contact. It is a disease that causes abortions in cows, and it also causes calves to be born unviable. It can be transferred to humans and it can make people very sick. Another major disease to be thinking about is pestivirus. Pestivirus has major economic implications to the beef industry. In northern Queensland, another disease to be thinking about is botulism. It mainly occurs in phosphorus deficient country where animals start eating bones. It causes paralysis of the animal and they usually die. The main ways to protect against botulism is to feed phosphorus to animals and also to vaccinate. Vaccines can cost money, but the biggest thing they protect you against is if your herd is naive to a certain disease. It can put you 12 months behind, 2 years behind when you're breeding. In regards to vaccination, you should be thinking of getting the animals vaccinated before specific periods of the year, such as calving, branding, pregnancy testing, or for bulls before joining. If you're vaccinating against 3-day sickness, you should be vaccinating before the wet season comes, because the wet season is when biting midges are going to be at their most prolific stage. The vaccination program for each individual class of animal depends on their productivity and their purpose within your enterprise. For example, steers would not need to receive a vaccination for leptospirosis because they're not a breeding animal. But they may need to still receive a vaccination for botulism if you're in phosphorus deficient country. The major vaccine for calves and weaners is 5-in-1 or 7-in-1. And you usually give that before branding and then at branding to protect calves from surgical procedures that are carried out on them. Once you embark on a vaccination program, you should see it through to get the best effects from that vaccine. The majority of vaccines require 2 shots. So they require initial shot and then they require another shot 6 to 8 weeks later. They also require an annual booster to protect them against that disease that you're vaccinating for. The records that you need to keep in your vaccination program include the actual vaccine that you're using, the batch number of the vaccine, the dose rate of the vaccine, and the expiry date of the vaccine. A national health declaration is a really good idea to be used if you're selling cattle on to people, because then they know what vaccines the animals have received and also whatever parasite control you've used for those animals. The vaccination program can be linked to the management tag of the animal, which can be recorded in weighing systems for easier use in regards to lifetime traceability of that beast. Vaccination is a no-brainer when it comes to animal production because it protects your business against disease implications and impacts. The best people to ask about what sort of vaccination programs are applicable to your herd are your local veterinarians, or you could contact Biosecurity Queensland for their advice, or a Beef Extension officer.